In massive protests in Nagaland's Mon today, furious residents have demanded an apology from Home Minister Amit Shah for his alleged false and fabricated statements in Parliament this week. Protesters burned an effigy of the Home Minister to underline the extent of their anger both against Shah and his allegedly incorrect statement and against the central government over the continued imposition of AFSPA or the Special Forces Act that they fear will be invoked to shield the guilty. The protesters, who included residents from the village of Oting, the home of the 12 of the 14 killed in the Nagaland encounter incident, were led by an apex body of tribes called the Konyak Union and have demanded an immediate apology from Amit Shah and the withdrawal of his statement from the parliament's records. A 1.5-year-old girl who had tested positive for the Omicron variant of the coronavirus in Pimpri-Chinchwad area of Pune district of Maharashtra recently has been discharged from hospital after recovering from the infection, while a 3-year-old boy who was also found infected with the new strain in the area is asymptomatic and keeping well. The 3-year-old boy is among the 4 new patients in Pimpri-Chinchwad Municipal Corporation area. The 3 others are all adults. A day after India bid farewell to the country's first Chief Defence of Staff, General Bipin Rawat, and his wife, killed in a chopper crash on Wednesday, General Rawat's daughters took his ashes to Haridwar today for immersion. The ashes were collected from Delhi's Brar Square Crematorium this morning, where the last rites were performed by General Rawat's daughters, Kritika and Tarini. They were immersed in the Ganga at Haridwar in the afternoon. An aircraft showered flower petals on exuberant farmers returning home following the end of their year-long agitation against the contentious farm laws. Thousands of farmers began their journey home after dismantling their makeshift accommodations at protest sites on the borders of Delhi. As the struggle came to an end, the farmers said they were very happy and relieved to return home.
Subscribe to One India channel and never miss an update.